This is the Xbox Adaptive Controller. Its main selling point is that it has these 3.5mm jacks, and you can use them to plug in external buttons and joysticks, allowing you to customize your setup to your needs. But it also has these two USB input ports, one on the left and one on the right. These are meant for plugging in USB joysticks like this. Historically, the controller was fairly limited in terms of what types of inputs it understood over these USB input ports. The idea was that if you wanted a left analog stick, you would plug something like this joystick into the USB port on the left side of the controller, and similarly, if you wanted a right stick, you would plug a joystick into the USB port on the right. If you plug the controller with two analog sticks into one of the ports, the Xbox Adaptive Controller would only see the left stick on that controller. Similarly, the number of buttons it understood on each port was limited, and it wouldn't see the D-pad at all. But in June 2024, a firmware update came out for the Xbox Adaptive Controller. And with that new firmware, it can now see two analog sticks, 12 buttons, and the D-pad on any controller plugged into either of the USB input ports. So, it is a big improvement, but the implementation still isn't perfect. For example, if you plug in the Stadia controller, the A, B, and X buttons don't work. The DualSense doesn't work at all, and forget about anything that would require some complex mapping like a keyboard or a mouse. And this is where HID Remapper comes in. HID Remapper is a universal adapter for USB input devices. It comes in many shapes and sizes. I think this form factor conveys its functionality well. Typically, you plug this side into a computer and plug some input device like a mouse or a keyboard or a game controller into this side. Then you can configure the HID Remapper to alter the inputs in some ways. Unlike the Xbox Adaptive Controller, it understands inputs from pretty much any USB input device. It can also send inputs to the Xbox Adaptive Controller in the format that it understands. And most importantly, it has a fairly powerful remapping system, allowing us to take USB input devices that look nothing like a game controller and make them compatible with the Xbox Adaptive Controller. So what we're going to do is, instead of plugging the HID Remapper into our computer, we're going to plug it into one of the USB input ports on the Xbox Adaptive Controller. Let's start with something straightforward. Let's connect our DualSense controller and let's use HID Remapper to make it compatible with the Xbox Adaptive Controller. I have already configured the HID Remapper for the DualSense, so I will just plug it into the Xbox Adaptive Controller. And I will plug the DualSense into it. The Xbox Adaptive Controller is connected to my computer for this demonstration, but of course it would work exactly the same when connected to an Xbox console. This is just a gamepad testing website. As you can see, it's receiving inputs from the Xbox Adaptive Controller. And as you can see, it's also receiving inputs from the DualSense that I have connected to the Xbox Adaptive Controller using HID Remapper. Both sticks work, the D-pad, and all the standard buttons work. Let me show you what the configuration looks like. To configure HID Remapper, I'm going to unplug it from the Xbox Adaptive Controller and plug it directly into my computer. This is what configuring HID Remapper looks like. You don't have to install any special software on your computer. You just go to this website where you can configure everything and then save the configuration on the device. All the remapping happens in hardware, so after we save the configuration, we can unplug the HID remapper from our computer and plug it into another computer, or in our case, into the Xbox Adaptive Controller. Let's connect to our HID remapper, open device, select our device, connect, and let's load the current configuration from it. This is what it looks like. I won't go into detail in this video. The important parts are the mappings that you can see here and the emulated device type in the settings tab. This needs to be set to XAC compatible. The mappings work like this. Whenever HID remapper receives an input like this from the device that's plugged into it, it sends out this input instead. That's why it's called HID remapper. It can map any input to any other input. In our case, we just map the DualSense buttons to buttons that the Xbox Adaptive Controller understands. I know the names in the input column don't seem to make a lot of sense, but don't worry, you can use the monitor tab to quickly check what types of inputs each device is sending. Then you just need to decide what buttons you want to map them to. Okay, bonus round. I said before that HID remapper is compatible with pretty much any USB input device. It means that we can use it to plug other devices into the Xbox Adaptive Controller and use them to play games on Xbox consoles. The devices don't even need to resemble a game controller. For example, let's try a keyboard. If you ever wanted to play Xbox games with a keyboard, even ones that don't support it natively, this is one way to do it. To save time, I'm going to load the configuration preset from the examples tab. And by the way, there is a lot of different configurations here. Some are very simple and just demonstrate some specific HID remapper feature, and some are fairly advanced. I'm going to load this one. Keyboard to XAC adapter. As you can see, there are some simple key to button mappings here, and we also have these five mappings that have expressions as their inputs. This is because the D-pad and the analog sticks are not simple one-to-one mappings. The expressions look something like this. It may seem a bit scary, but if you just want to use them without modification, then you don't need a thorough understanding of how they work. Or if you just want to change the keys that they use for the D-pad and the sticks, then it's also fairly straightforward. Okay, let's save this configuration to our HID remapper. Let's unplug it from our computer and plug it back into the Xbox Adaptive Controller. Let's plug a keyboard into it. And let's see what happens. The WASD keys work as the left analog stick. The arrow keys work as the D-pad. The numeric keypad would work as the right analog stick if my keyboard had a numeric keypad. And the keys here work as the buttons. Backspace is view. Enter is menu. Of course, you can change the mapping if you want. A couple of things to note here. As you can see, I plugged the HID remapper into the USB input port on the left side of the Xbox Adaptive Controller. If I plugged it into the USB port on the right side instead, it would still work, but some of the inputs would be different. The left and right analog sticks would be swapped, and some of the buttons would be rearranged as well. This is probably to keep the legacy behavior. As I've said previously, when you plugged something into the right side USB port, only one analog stick would work, and it would work as the right analog stick. So they probably didn't want to break existing setups when they released the new firmware. Another thing is that, as you can see, the key that I wanted to work as the left and right triggers is mapped to X1 and X2. Again, this is just how it works. The Xbox Adaptive Controller doesn't map any of the buttons on the controllers that are plugged into it to the triggers. But what you can do is you can configure X1 and X2 to work as the triggers. You can do this from the Xbox Accessories app on your computer or on your Xbox console. Okay, that is it for now. Remember that we've only scratched the surface of what's possible here. For example, we are not limited to connecting just one device. We could connect multiple controllers or a mouse in addition to a keyboard, using a USB hub or a version of HID Remapper that has a built-in USB hub. And the remapping engine in HID Remapper can do all sorts of cool stuff, like layers, macros, turbo, toggle functionality on buttons, and a lot of other neat things. If you want to learn more about it, including where to get or how to make your own HID Remapper, take a look at our other videos and the project's GitHub repository. Thanks for watching.